All right, boys, I think it's time to play some games. Dude, I can't play some Roblox today. I don't know what it is. I'm kind of in the mood to play Roblox. Can I talk my shit again, even if I don't hit it? We haven't played it in so long, bro. It's fun. My hat, my shoes, my coat, Louis Vuitton sticks. With Donald Teller Versace, that's Louis Vuitton, bitch. I think Hennessy, I drink. I'm gone off that Bacardi, Limon, and Corona. I'm zoned. Play this. What the fuck is that? Caught right into our dights. Who? I'm like Nas Barkley. Me, Charles Barkley. I'm Pop the Barkers. I'm Hood the Parkers. While y'all was who? In limbo, I raised the bar up. I touched on everything. Married to the game, rock the chain, set a wedding ring. Y'all bridesmaids catch the garter. On nights when gay romance, cameras flash so much that I gotta do that yayo dance.
You wanna be Gemma so bad? Did Gemma play Roblox? After each and every show, a couple dykes in the band. It's easy, the hood love to listen to cheese. Bruh. Oh, there's Mike on this. Hello? Hey, hello. Can you guys hear me? Hello? Guys? Any of you guys got a mic? Guys? Hello? Bro, you're ruining the fun of people. Can you stop that, please? Wait, how do I get in a car? Forward. Oh shit. Move! Move, bro! Yo, you wanna get in a car? We can go together. It'll be scary. Hop in. Is there any one seater? Fuck. Please don't fuck me up. Don't fuck me up, man. It's a child. Bro, I didn't... Why do you guys make everything weird? Not everything has to have sexual connotations behind them. You guys are weird. You guys are weird, bro. Hello? No one even has a mic on the server. I'll go faster. I'm not a person. Wait, the track just disappears. Wait, oh, it's such a bait. Oh, good one, game. Good one. Good one. Ah, yes. Bro. Oh my god, go faster! We're gonna collide! LeBron, can you go? What are you doing? Get out! You can't get out of my car! Get the fuck out! You know what? Fuck it, let's go back. Fuck it, let's go back. Let's kill both of us and then you're stuck. So fucking cool, man. You're so cool. I'm trying to fix my car. I'm sorry. The fuck is your... Is he just gonna stand there? Oh my god, you prick! You're so lame, man. Die. Bro, this whole server is busted, man. What the fuck is that? What the fuck am I looking at? So I think it's time I get some new drip. I don't like my character. Can you guys link me some cool outfits so I can, or cool like pieces so I can make a cool character? I'm good. Okay. Oh, I'll look for my... I'll look for myself then. How do I look at, like, the market? How do I look at the market, bro? Wait, is my sister online? She ain't. Why do I have low tier god in my friends list? Chat, how do I buy like outfits? The fuck is this? Customize. Oh, okay. Purchased. Why did I buy this? Bro, this character went hard, bro. This character went hard. Why did I ever get off of this one? Oh, yeah. I remember now. All right, let's see if I can... How do I buy, though? Shop for more. Devin, you can get this for free? I'll take it. It's free body parts. I'll take it. Get. Why not? I'll take that. Bro, all these are free. You guys have no... reason to not have good skins in Roblox. I see you guys walking around as default skins. Bro, you can get these free skins like Parker for free and Cameron for free. And Glenn dies in The Walking Dead. Dies. He dies. Glenn dies. You can get these for... You can get these skins in the fucking game. Fuck was... Oh, my Xbox has turned on. Huh. Buy this skin. The fuck even is it? How do you wear it? What type? It's a shoulder. I don't like this, man. Buy this. No. I'm not paying you 3 Robux for this, bro. You're actually charging money for that? This is kind of fucking... This is kind of good, actually. Try it on. You know what? I kind of like that. I kind of like that. Honestly. Bye. Customize. That's kind of good. Why'd you have that many Robux? Okay, so basically, what happened was I left Builders Club on my account because I bought it one time. I can't remember why. I bought it and it like all stacked up and added. Unfortunately. Bro, I need to find like actual good skins. This guy might have more good ones. Marinus. You got any other good skins, bro? Just the monkey? Oh, here we go. Oh shit, he's got a load of good stuff. No. No. Not Russell, man. All this is kind of shit, actually, bro. I think I'm content with my orangutan head. There's got to be something cool in here, though. If I type in
heat. And then look in Avatar shop. There's got to be some good shit in there. This is all bad. This is all bad. How does that even look on my character? Try it on. You can't even see it. Oh, I'm fine with this. So what's a good game to play on Roblox? What's a good game? Play this game with chat in a private server. No, you guys will just ram me and shit. You guys will just ram me.
Roblox battle.
Hello? Bro, my whole fucking OBS just crashed, man. It keeps crashing. My lights went on and off for a sec, but my PC didn't go off. Is it maybe a power surge in my building or something, chat? That doesn't make sense, though. Why would the lights go off but not my PC? Huh. That's just weird. Play this if you can't play Red Dead Redemption today. Is this that one game we played forever ago? The Wild West. Oh, God. Oh, God. Don't scan backstretch, I played it before a long time ago. Where's the music at? Oh God, what is the? You've been jailed for what? Bro, why'd they put me in jail for? I just got in. Come on. Shit, man. Hey, let me out. Why am I playing as LeBron James? Let me out. Five, four, three. 2-1 I put the new fungies on the G. I'm gonna do the bloody bottoms on the knee. Hello? Hey man. Hey man, I'm new in the town. I was wondering if you could show me around. Josh. I'm new in the town. I was wondering if you could show me around. Door. Wait. My PC was lagging. He said GG. Rematch. He just fucking died. Rematch me. How do I accept it?
This town's way too big, brother.
One v one me. Stop declining it. Bro. Get out of my way. These fuckers are in my way, bro! You're in my fucking way and I cannot see out of my peripherals. Oh, fuck this, bruh. I'ma start killing some people. Wait, a mission? A store. Buy a pickaxe. Oh, we should go to the mines. How much money I got? $600? How the fuck do I have so much money? Should I buy a tier 3 pickaxe? A trustworthy pickaxe? Go to the mines? I'll buy this. I bet I can make so much money in the mines. Why? Why is this game so lagged? What do you want, man? Am I still alive? Try hard. Nah, bro, what the fuck is happening? Why is my internet so laggy today? Like, everything's fucking up. Why is everything fucking up today? Let me try a different server. Put the new 4G's on the Jeep. Have you tried this? Wait, let me. I'm enjoying this right now. I want to get into a different server. Go to the military base. Can you get aeroplanes on this? There's no way. It's a Red Dead Redemption. Do they even have aeroplanes back here? Where the fuck is a military base at? I kinda wanna go mining though. Already owned. Wait, it gave me it now. So someone probably DDoSed that server because they're a loser. They saw I was in it and they like DDoSed it or some shit. Where would you go mining even? Plus haste to cool your horse. Oh, there's a mines right here. Oh no, it's not. We'll find them. We'll find them. Who the fuck's shooting at me? I say we kidnap someone and hold them for ransom. We find like a group of people. We talk. We divide the group, kidnap someone, and then ask for ransom for them. That's a good fucking idea. What the fuck? I'm sorry, it was a joke. I was just joking. Help me! These kids, man, they're literally ruining the fucking game for me. All right, next game. Randomizer. This game contains copyrighted audio. Is this a warning to keep background music on or off as we attempt to mute most of the copyrighted audios from this game? You can turn audios off in the setting tabs. Have fun. On. I ain't scared. What even is this though? Play. Tutorial? I didn't know. Tutorial? Deployment. Oh my god, it's so ugly. Vegeta da- The fuck is going on? I have like the worst gun in the game. How do I get a better gun? Firework cannon. This ain't working for me. Oh, here we go. Oh shit! Finally a good weapon. My sensitivity is so fucking high. I was clearly AFK X-Rick. I'm pretty sure this is the guy who's DDoSing the servers. How am I missing with a shotgun? Put a 0.10. Maybe that'll be better sensitivity. That's way better. Please, I'm sorry. What the fuck am I playing? Come on, come to me. Fortnite! You're so cringe, man. You're so cringe. I'm like fucking Katniss! I'm like Cat Piss! Oh my god, I'm on a 3-kill streak. Eat a chocolate bar. No, I can't die. That gun was so good, man. AirPod shotty. AirPod shotty. How am I missing? You're a little tonguing bitch, Seldis. Oh, this is the worst gun in the game. I always die with this. No way, die! How are you alive? If I die before killing this guy, Next game, that was too fucking chaotic. That game was too fucking much. Have you tried this? I don't really feel like playing like these Battlefield type games, if I'm being honest. Test Place. Now this is a better game. It's Phantom Forces. What was that? Mineshaft the Intruder. The Hunger Game. No way this is real. Do people actually play this? Hunger Games has been revived in fucking Roblox. Yo, hello guys. Can any of you guys hear me? This is just like the movie with a Katniss. May the odds be in your favor. Tributes left 13. Wait, do we have to wait for them to be done? This could take forever. I guess we'll just wait. Oh, this is simple parkour. Like, it's easy for someone like me. It's a simple parkour. See? Very simple. Very simple, really. These fucking noises. Fuck the parkour, bro. No one needs to know how to do that. Anyone can do that if they wanted. This is where the hard shit is. Right here. 8 people remain. How many people are in this lobby? Because all I see is dead bodies. All I see is dead bodies. El Goblino, you're gonna die.
You're not scaring nobody, little pup.
Hey, Deadly Guy 1, you're dead, bro. I'm telling you, you're going to die. Bro, I'm telling you, you're the... Do you know what? Actually, I'm gonna target you. You know what? I've never targeted anyone before. I'm targeting you.
Good, bro. Just make you an easy kill.
How's it gonna make me an easy kill? Go on, enlighten me.
We all know how ash you are, bro. We all know how ash you are.
Bro, I'm not ash. You just haven't seen me unleash the demon. The demon has not left me yet.
We will see.
You're gonna see the demon come outside of my body. The demon is gonna fucking come inside of me. Outside of me. Oh shit, you can buy outfits? Where's Katniss? Guys, can anyone hear me? Where did you get the bow from, man? Do you mind telling me? Combat spear. Please tell me you could throw it. What's the fucking point if you can't throw it?
Yeah, snipers, join up, come on.
We've got like 4 more people. Okay, jump if you're a sniper. Jump if you're a stream sniper. Okay, this guy's just fucking me, so gee, I wonder. Bro, oh my god, are you serious? Guys, let me play the game. Don't target me. If you're all snipers, like, please just let me play the game. Don't be like, don't be a cunt. You don't have to be a cunt.
Oh, but you can target me though.
Yeah, because you're an asshole, deadly guy.
Yo, that Ellie girl.
Oh my god, bro. I gotta play Hunger Games music. I'm searching Hunger Games on Spotify. Hunger Games music. Hunger Games by Bayesian Canadian. Alright, we're gonna win. Three left. Games, I wanna win, I win it all. I'm not teaming. You should've learned how to play. Yes, I win it all. So yeah, I win it all. I wanna win all day. I'm not teaming. You should've seen my last Hunger Games. This shit went hard back in the day, man. Holy fuck. Hunger Games music. Bro, how can I spectate? Oh, you can spectate. District 5. Oh shit, they beefing. Yo, gay's ass! Seek gay's ass! What fucking combat is this, man? Fucking shoot his ass! Stop with this jumping dog shit! You're trash! Don't eat the berries! He ate the berries! Oh wait, these actually give him health and shit. Oh, here we go. Gif Schneider. Who will win, chat? But he's actually dying from eating the berries. I have 11 kills. What about you? Bro, no one cares. Can you hurry up and fight? Nobody cares. Wrap it up. We are bored. Oh shit. My money's on Brutus. Oh shit, he's hit me in the fucking head with a spear. You got 7 kills. You're about to be the fucking 8th, bitch. He's got to be low. Jesus, how is he? What? He's been hit twice in the head with 2 spears. He's on 90 HP. How? How? Oh, that's his hunger. Oh, his health is 47. Seventeen HP, come on! Brutus, you fucking whooped his ass. Good shit, Brutus. 2 kills. Now put me in. Put me in. Put me in. Wait, who's on my... Eric?
I have not worked in my unit else like this. Like,
please, someone be good on my district. Please have someone good on my district, please.
Like, I'm so over here. I hate Corona. I don't
Please, am I not in the game? Where am I? Brutus! We're with the winner! Deadly guy, you're the game maker, pussy. You're not even gonna be in there. You're
listen
lucky.
Listen there, buckaroo.
Go on, what?
I can handle a weapon better than anybody on this server.
Yeah? Let's see how you fucking handle these fucking weapons then. A fucking bow and a spear and
listen
a fucking axe.
Listen here, buddy. I grew up in the US of A.
Yeah.
The only 3 things that I love is oil, weapons, and women. God bless America.
Amen. Amen. I'll see you in the arena, buddy. I'm taking that guy out first. I fucking hate him. Everything he stands for. Will step off your pedestal or you're early or you'll be blown up. What? Weapon!
Susan, I got a spare.
Oh, you really want to go? Bitch! Shit! Dick! Ah! Why are you on me? You're so lame. You're so cringe, bro. You're so cringe. That is so cringe. I don't get to play the fucking game, bro. Put me in another one. No, I want to play that. I want to actually play. I don't want to wait around. Oh my god, put me in one that's like... That's so cringe, dude. Why does it keep putting me in the same one? Servers. Doing this one. Bye. Oh, here we go. Let's go. Let's fucking go. Let's go, dude. What's up, Mr. Perfect? Welcome to the stream, man. I switched to put wait. It was his first message in my chat. Welcome. Chat, he's so EP. Leave him alone. I'm gonna put him down here. He's on. He's in front of my mouse, so I keep hitting him. Keep knocking him. There's two people left. I'm gonna play epic duel music. Epic duel music. Epic music for Yu-Gi-Oh! Dueling? Is that what I just saw? No, where'd it go? Epic music for Yu-Gi-Oh! Duels. Oh shit! Nah, they got bangers in here. They got some fucking bangers in it. Put me in District 5. Hoyo. Imagine dueling with this fucking music, bro. Dora? Lily! Lily's my teammate. Yo, Lily, where you at? Lily! What is this emote? Nah. What is that emote? The fuck is a nah? Lily! Where you at, Lily? Lily! These songs. Oh my god. I'm going to the center for a weapon. Ah! I see an axe. A fucking sickle! Diego, come on then! Oh fuck that, he has a bow. The only thing I can throw? What's the best weapon? Oh, the club seems good, so does a sickle. No, I got no food! Get your ass back here, boy. Hey, boy! No solution. Strong on the toe. Boy! Quite unfair. Quite a pair. No box office. All the problems make me wanna go like a bad girl straight to finish. Why is it lag? Welcome to the show. You're a failure playing. Oh my... The ranged weapons are bullshit, bro. The ranged weapons are such bullshit. Nah, I'm fucking out of this bitch. So now I'm just being targeted by these two cunts. They don't run out of... Oh, shit, wait. I have Kuni. Can I eat that? Cat, stay down. Yeah, now what, Dubby? Now what, pussy? Come on. Oh, you're getting fucked from two angles. You're getting fucked. Okay, all right, let's truce. Truce, or I'll kill you. And I will fucking end your life. I'm not kidding. Alright, truce. Kill the guy behind you. Kill Diego! I'm sorry, I didn't mean to kill you, bro. My fault. Oh, you're dead. How is this bitch still alive? Oh, this game sucks, chat. This game actually fucking sucks. Kill his ass! My kunai does no damage. I'm killing you. Come back here now. Get your ass back here. Oh, yeah, just keep running, bitch. I'm sorry. What the fuck is this? This is World War Me! No, dog. I'm actually about to die from thirst. I'm gonna get water. Can you just drink from the lake? Thirst. Die now. Please die. Die peacefully. I've had enough of your existence. I will never be free. You're shit. I'm gonna eat your remains. I've got 9 hunger. I have to eat her. Die! How the fuck are you still alive? Let's go. I have so many fucking weapons now. How the fuck is she throwing this? What was she throwing? The javelin? I need food. You're sponsored by T Plus with bread. Arigato. I got sponsored with bread. Someone please sponsor me! No one's sponsoring you, little pup. How slow is this weapon? It's so bad! I'm excuse a Q9. Late nights messing up my sleep, so I'm flustered. Taking out aggression with my pen because I trust it. Writing, trying to get myself a lamb color cuss for the game. If I'm hanging by his chain, click bang. Feeling rage, feeling fire with my brain. Feeling sane, and it's all we feel the flame. 45 to my brain, playing more and please help. No glory. Oh, and then you run, like. What a little bitch. You're gonna have to fight me eventually, bitch. I will keep throwing kunai till you die. What don't you understand? Fight me, pussy. Your only opportunity is to come at me. How are you dodging every fuck? How? Bitch! God, you suck. I'm gonna eat your bread now. God, you fucking suck. There's four people left. They said I didn't have any throwing weapons. Get better, noob. What other songs are in this dueling playlist? This is World War Me. Well, I have extra bread here still. A sponsor! Sponsors you with a landmine? This music is so fucking bad. So bad. Use your tomahawk. I have a tomahawk? Bro, I don't have a tomahawk. What are you talking about? I have an axe. There's no tomahawk. No one says tomahawk. Okay, how the fuck do you say it then? Tomahawk. Same shit, car. Who cares? Same shit. Oh, I'm at thirst! I'm gonna die! I'm dying of thirstiness! Please, someone sponsor me! No, that game sucked. That game fucking sucked. It was trash.
Thanks for the joke.
Amazing gameplay.
Play this one next. No. Oh, what is this? Hunting Season. It's a horror game. Eh, it doesn't look good. Criminality. Free room fighting game? Bro, this so changed this shit. You don't like it? Oh, this music's pretty good, man. So I kind of want to play what's it called? Switch Sports. No, I don't want to play Isaac. I can't play Switch Sports, dude. Do I have it downloaded? Let me see. Use this guy. I don't know if I have it downloaded. It's a hard road to heaven. Fuck, I don't. Okay, well, download it. Let's see how long it take. We put our faith. Kingdom, the kingdom. No more Roblox. I'm kind of over it. It was fun for a little bit. Holy angels defending. Father, we put our faith. Terraria? I will never play Terraria on this stream, buddy. I'm gonna be honest with you. It's just not my game. How could he not be the greatest? In my bed under the Why is this not for me, bro? It just ain't for me. I don't think Terraria is for everyone. Fashionably late, I'm just glad that you made it. The best is yet to come, I'm just glad that you waited. I don't think it's that good show. Too hard? I've played through Calamity Terraria. I just don't think I'd ever play it on stream. Use this gospel for protection. It's a hard road to heaven. Oh. We call on. Wait, I'm downloading Switch Sports chat. I've played this shit in ages. I played this shit forever. Demons are trembling. Holy angels defending. Yes, we put our faith. A lot of damaged souls, I done damaged those. And then my arrogance took a camera pose. Caught with a trunk, a berry man of Lowe's. They weren't working. When the slammer closed. Minecraft gets boring after 30 minutes, dog shit game. They give you rape talk. Terraria gets boring after an hour. Blindfolded on this road, watch me faith walk. Just hold on to your brother when it's bro, there's always that like one fucking that one friend that ropes you into playing another fucking server of Minecraft. You guys play it for like a week and have never touched it again for like another year. Happens all the fucking time. But Minecraft is fun to revisit. Terraria, I get bored so quick. Minecraft is fun to redo it. I can't do it. I can't do the same with Terraria, bro. It just ain't for me. Ain't for me. Red Dead Redemption 1, you lying motherfucker. My Red Dead Redemption 1 game broke. I ordered a new one, but it didn't come today. It will be here soon, I'm sure, man. I'll play it, don't you worry. I got told it runs like shit on emulators, chat, so I never bothered with it. I wish you could play games where it fucking loads or where it downloads, man. Hope your Xbox gets the Red Ring of Death. Why? Why would you say such a mean thing? You're fucked for that, man. I didn't break Red Dead Redemption 1 on purpose, chat. I never did it on purpose, okay? it fell over. It was a mishap. I don't break games on purpose. I've never seen a Xbox Slim get the red ring of death, though. I got one on my white Xbox, like, when it first came out, whenever that was. But I never got one on the black one. Did the black Xbox ever get red rings of death, or no? Did they fix it by then? It can. Xbox Slims don't have the red ring of death. Mine never got one. Only the white Xbox gets them. Okay. Cream Pie is trapped forever inside that disc. Cream Pie was from Red Dead Redemption 2, bro. Wrong game. Dude, I want to replay Red Dead Redemption 2. Red Dead Redemption 2 is so much better than 1. It's so much better than number 1, so far. But I've not really played much of Red Dead Redemption 1, so... who knows? Never, Clob. Stop asking. Hero is playing Breath of the Wild. Maybe you should try. Oh, shit. He's playing Breath of the Wild?
Hey, ladies and germs in the chat room.
How many hours on Breath of the Wild do I have?
The goodest of Fridays. Hey, just a little pun for you guys there. Hope you guys ate plenty of salmon. I know I did, that's for sure. Blood Trail.
I played that shit for 85 hours or more. I think even more than that, though. Jesus. Breath of the Wild is so much content in it, though. Like, and all the DLC is really good as well. All the DLC and Breath of the Wild are good as fuck. People can't add me on Switch. I have my friends turned off. I have to add you.
Therapy up in the chat room, thirsty ass people this morning. But anyhow,
play Roblox Frontlines.
I want to play Switch Sports. I wish I had someone to play with, though. Cool Senny. I think he's taking a day off. I don't know if he's going to be around. Let me see. Don't go wasting your emotions. Lay all your love on me. Europe, he's live early. He's playing Breath of the Wild, though. I don't want to take him away from that. Dude, this right here, the boys that are here right now, this is the core Zoilers. You guys are the core Zoilers. If you were here right now, you guys are the core of the community. I need you guys to start typing more. Now. No, you guys are the fucking core of the community. And it shows that you guys are watching me, regardless who's live. And I appreciate that, boys. I appreciate that. Thank you. Thank you for being here. So are you taking a little dance break? Hold on, dude. Let me get out my chair and dance real quick. Take a seat, Bumpu. Oh my god, I haven't heard this song in forever. Alright, start, here we go. What if I step on the cat while playing or something, though? No! I stepped on it! No! Bro! A fucked up day. Fat people ruin everything. Okay, it had nothing to do with me being fat. I mean, shut up. Does anyone play this anymore? No. Wait, really? New items. Warbo's under the desk, he's fine. He's sleeping. Furry! Oh, let's do sword fight. Sword fight me. Come on, pussies. Please tell me someone has this game. Oh!
Chambara.
People actually do have this shit, okay. Sword.
Here we go.
Okay. Don't stand too close to the television. Come on, pussy! Oh, you're gonna get fucked. You're dead. What?
Round one.
Oh, you're fucked.
Ready? Fight!
Fuck! You can see the connectivity in the bottom right. It's lagging.
Round two.
Where the fuck are you sniping from, bro? Vietnam?
Fight.
God, you suck. That shit was too easy.
Got it.
Oh, we can do a different game. Fuck Chambara, bro. Why does your character look less fucked up than you? That was just mean, man. Come on now. Tennis, which is a good one. Volleyball? How do you do volleyball again? You go like that, right? Like that?
Volleyball. Here we go.
Like that. Make sure you have enough space around you. Okay. Jamie, mate, I need you to do fucking well here. I don't remember how to play, Jamie. Wait, I'm gonna say thumbs up. Oh yeah, it's all about timing. Ah! Fuck!
Zero, one.
Oh, it just really hurt my finger. Oh. Oh god, on my stomach. Ah! Fuck!
Zero, two.
Oh my god, that was perfect almost. I get it now. Perfect. Wait. Let's go, Jamie. Watch me block this bitch. These guys are gonna block it. Rematch now. That's fucking bullshit. I'm gonna need you to move out of the way, buddy. I don't want to step on you. You can sit here. Okay, he's going down the side. My finger's actually bleeding from a blunt injury. Oh my god, it's swelling up. Bro, it's actually swelling up. Nice. Now your finger's just fat. The dock! Did you not save that? Doc, you're trolling! Bro, look at the capture. This is why I wasn't playing right, look. Look. Okay, so now you're not gonna do it. Now you won't do it, huh? Oh, really? Here we go. Well, he was jumping for it, anyway. No, it's not a war boat car, bro. He was jumping for it. All right, let's do... tennis. Chat, what was that other game that we used to play on the Switch? It was really good. Like 50 games or something. That game was good, bro. It had like loads of different games. I'm gonna roll this shit. Come on.
Play.
How is that out? What? No, skip the shit, please. Yalla! Wait! Yeah. What is the point of it then? Ah, get fucked, bitch.
One,
get fucked.
Four.
You see that? so bad. You don't even realize how bad you are. The comeback is crazy. It's fucking insane. So bad. So bad. That's the game, man. Wait, is that not it? Wait, what? Are you not entertained? Yeah, you put the rage emoji, bitch.
Match point.
Come on. Oh, you're so bad. Oh, you're so bad. Oh, you're so fucking bad.
Game, set,
I call it a dub. I call it a dub. I call it, what you call it? A dub. I call it a dub. Fucking roll. Earrings? Put them on. Put them on. Oh wait, I can't put on face. Fuck. I can't put on any of this stuff because I have a me head. But I want to do that again. That's fun. Give me another tennis game. Nicholas Fran de Estremo.
Here we go.
How can you play three-person tennis? What? Oh, they're on a team together. Wait, I feel like I'm gonna lose now.
Play.
Oh, idiot! Idiot!
One,
you got fucked. Literally gave me a 3 point, bitch. Wait, why did I do that?
One on.
Stop going for the wire! Stop! Stop! So bad.
2-1.
Unsavable. That's bullshit. That's literally bullshit. Nice. I'm glad I didn't connect to that. I'm so glad. Oh my god, I almost went for it. Oh my god, I almost hit it. One more, come on.
Match point.
Come on.
I'm actually a tennis pro. When playing doubles, use the front person when they hit a ball diagonally away from your guy in the back.
Yeah.
Six, four.
I'd be devastated at that. I'd be so mad at that. All right, chat, I want to play the other game. This game's fun, but the other game is way more fun. I don't know if anyone plays that shit, though. Do I even have it downloaded? It's been so long. Um, 51 Clubhouse Games. This game is so good. This game is so good, bro. How long is it gonna take? 8 minutes? It's fine, I don't mind waiting. Zo, please give me a sub to Lyric. What's in it for me? What's in it for me, man? Bro, I'm already tired of doing a bare minimum physical activity. That's not true. I just, the games are kind of stale after a while. And I want to play the other games that don't require me to stand up. Not because it requires me to stand up, just because they're better. You know? You know? What was that, Spleen?
Never mind. I'm not going to try to ride him. I'm not going to try to ride him. It's music to my ears, baby! Call that a dub! I call it a dub. What you call it a dub? I call it a dub. What you call it? A dub. It's easy. It's easy. I don't know what you call that, but it's a dub. What up, Sojo? What up, Sojo? Oh my god, what a dub. What a freaking dub. Sorry, Lime.
Police chase? Wait, really? How the fuck is this the police chase, bro?
You were having a heart attack.
Okay,
as
man.
They would normally control it. Now, Mark, have you heard anything about spike strips, or did this tire just give way, perhaps because they were driving so fast, or
the
tires
fuck is
were
that in the bottom left?
I have not heard anything about spike strips, and I actually learned technology here at the assignment desk where we record all of the radio traffic that the LAPD uses, and I was able to go back in time and listen to the very start of this pursuit. I did not hear any deployment of any spike strips, but I do, you just reminded me of something that I did hear that I wanted to bring up. Apparently, I believe it was at Manchester and across, I can't remember what it was, this vehicle was involved in a collision. And oddly, I swear I heard them say it collided with a group of mannequins on the sidewalk. So it might have been like a sidewalk store that had like fashion mannequins out. But at first, the air unit thought that it was people, but it ended up being just mannequins. So this collision did damage this vehicle slightly, but I don't think that there were any injuries on the sidewalk when.
This is an LAPD pursuit. And we have also seen him rolling down the windows a couple of times, going through intersections pretty erratically. As Sandra mentioned, he's hit at least two people. Maybe that's where the majority of this damage came from, because Mike said he hasn't really seen the opportunity for them to put out a spike strip. This started happening around 12:15 for this pursuit, so it hasn't really been going on that long. A lot of times we see these pursuits, they'll follow from the air, but when they get too erratic and dangerous.
Is the bottom right the suspect? I'm confused.
But it looks like LAPD is staying pretty close.
Yeah, and he has slowed down significantly. We don't know if that's because he's forced to, because of the damage to the vehicle. Lewis, you pointed out he's got damage to at least one tire, riding on the rim there, significantly impairing his ability to control that truck. Mike Case overhead in Sky 5. Mike, we've got a number of things that make this more damage, more dangerous. First of all, he's got the damage to the vehicle, right? So it's harder to control. He's a shooting suspect. He might have a weapon inside there. And this is a large vehicle, a very heavy vehicle. If he hits someone, they're going to feel it.
Well, you're absolutely right. And in addition to that, just the fact that he may be armed and a person in the back seat that we can't see because of the tinted windows. He made an earthbound turn on, let's see.
Turn? The fuck's a earthbound turn?
Up from the 105 freeway, so we can kind of see him go north. But this is about the closest we can get to him. So he's slowed down into regular normal traffic speeds, but as you could tell, TV5, yes we can. That'd be great.
He was heading west.
2,500 for TV5 over the 405, correct? Great, thank you. We'll maintain
2,500. As Mike mentioned, there are some restrictions in the area.
Oh, you're biting my neck. Chill out,
because
bro.
He's pretty close to LAX right now.
Look at how he bites my hands. Is this normal?
Screen trying to get away from the LAPD. This is a desperate shooting suspect. One, possibly two people
in that truck.
It's a very heavy truck. There is some damage to the front. You can't see it right now, but the passenger side, he is riding on the rim, making his way through surface streets right now, already involved in at least one collision. We don't have an update yet on what happened to the people in that car, but he clipped that car trying to get through an intersection. So again, we don't know if anybody is injured, but this guy is considered dangerous, and we have to assume that if he's a shooting suspect, he has a weapon inside that vehicle.
Oh, yeah,
and
fuck.
We're assuming that LAPD and officials will treat this a little differently, especially if the vehicle comes to a stop it or is immobilized and not able to move, because they treat these situations differently.
But it's really in a police chase going 20 miles per hour, to be honest.
The driver is armed. He has been through El Segundo, Hawthorne, Lenox, and Englewood so far, as Sandra mentioned, on surface streets, slowing down substantially here. He was going a lot faster earlier, but at that time, the front tire was intact, and right now, it seems like he's riding on that rim. But he's staying in this area, which we often see a lot if someone's familiar with an area.
Warbing. That's a cute emote.
He's crisscrossing a little bit here, too. Still unclear, as we've mentioned, if there's one person in this vehicle or two. That will change the way that LAPD officers treat this as well once this vehicle comes to an end.
No
however that happens.
Kind of prince oil kind of cream.
Bro, I could not possibly get a cat cam on this cam. It doesn't stop moving. It does not stop moving.
Side of the road.
So dangerous.
And going through an intersection.
Yeah, he's
here.
Done this a couple times.
Right now, it's trying to climb out my window. So, like, it can't get out of it. It's impossible, but it's trying.
Perhaps north of the 2-4s, TV5, copy.
One thing that's good about this, Mike Case, if you're with us, traffic a little lighter because we've got a holiday weekend.
I don't want to call him Warbo, so I'm defaulting to the word it.
Lighter up in the air, Sandra. I tell you that we're right over the top of LAX, and as you can imagine, every jet in the world is descending upon us here, both 2425 complexes here. But anyway, he made an eastbound turn on one of the major streets. He's coming into a parking lot. Maybe that means we'll see what's going to happen here. But again, a shooting suspect or an assault suspect. Yeah, how they're able to navigate.
I feel like he's about to slow down, pull out a gun, and shoot at the cops. I'm actually terrified that's going to happen.
It's just unbelievable. It's got to be adrenaline. So he's coming this way, westbound again, towards the 405.
Why is he going so slow?
And We're just crossing over the top of the runway. Why would he go so slow otherwise? We'll see what's going to happen next. And did he want to get on the freeway? Nope, he doesn't want to do that.
Oh, wow.
And we'll see what happens.
I think he's probably assuming that he can't go fast enough on the freeway, especially with that damaged tire there. But he looked like he was making that turn, and then at the
he got hit by spike strips.
Changed his mind. This is a large vehicle too. It looks like dual doors and the
cool Lester.
So again, a heavy vehicle, definitely damaged, possibly armed, with the suspect who is the driver here, wanted for a shooting. And we don't know if the shooting that allegedly occurred prior to this, one of the reasons why they were doing this pursuit, was deadly or not. That has not been confirmed to us. But definitely a dangerous situation in terms of driving on the opposite side of the street and also going through intersections. We saw earlier, if you're just joining us, this driver, there were two vehicles.
So he's a murder suspect?
He basically bumped one out of the way, just an innocent driver. Out doing, you know, their daily deeds, and really interesting to see that LAPD staying so close to him as well.
Yeah, you have to wonder if they're going to try a pit maneuver here when he gets out in the open. It wouldn't
attempted
take much
murder.
For him to lose control of this vehicle right now. When he made a turn, Lou, just a few moments ago, I saw that tire just kind of jerk. I actually can't even call it a tire, that wheel, down on the rim. Usually at this point, we'd see there, you could see it wobbling. It looks like it's going to come off.
Oh, my God.
Struggling to keep control. Usually at this point, we'd see sparks
Where?
Start to fly
okay.
and things
okay.
like that. So, again, this is a shooting suspect, LAPD, in pursuit through the Inglewood area. For the most parts, we've seen him, and there
it's
are the sparks.
Sparking.
Just as we thought.
Oh, yeah.
So it's very loud
Which
inside that vehicle for him right now. He's He's got
to
smell that burning and know that this is going to come to an end very soon.
And that's where
that's
you
a
know,
GG.
We've spoken over the years.
But at this point, just give up. You're just making
that,
more like laws breaking
once
for
they
yourself.
Do come to a stop, especially
just
if
give
they
up,
are armed,
bro.
They have to treat the situation differently.
It's adding more
where
time.
It becomes even more dangerous because obviously we don't know the mental capacity right now of this person, or if they're upset, or if they're on drugs, or if they've been drinking, or if they're just wired. So they have to be super careful about how they approach the truck. And specifically, too, it looks like he's in a residential area, which, you know, there's children around. Obviously, Good Friday. So it's a holiday weekend, as you had mentioned.
Good Friday,
so not as
bro.
Much traffic on the road. But still, it always
Yo,
makes us nervous when they get into the neighborhoods because there are innocent passengers or pedestrians, rather, walking, kids playing. And if this guy is armed and he does have to come to an abrupt stop because of the vehicle, it just makes everyone really nervous as to how this wraps up. Mike, where are we exactly at this point?
Well, we were asking ourselves that same question. He just turned off of Manchester southbound, now a westbound turn. That's the police, I think it's Air 18 or 16 that's over the top of him, given the black and whites on the ground an idea. Look at that damage, how that's dipped off on the right side.
It's coming to the end, bro. I want
to
see the end of this chase.
Folks from driving on these the way they are. It's nuts. Anyway, we are still north of LAX. We're holding our position. Hopefully, if he doesn't move much more, we can hold this shot. But again, north of LAX.
Oh, I think they can't go too close to the flight area. They can't fly
bit.
Over near LAX.
That's good.
It's kind of smart to go that way.
The area. But and he's going to go southbound. Yeah. We'll get you that street, and it's time for him to pull over.
Yeah. Ow, my fucking foot,
driving
bro.
Driving on the wrong Boulevard. Side of the road.
Yep. Airport Boulevard, southbound.
Okay, so he's sort of out of the residential area now, which is good because Lou was saying, you know, a
Stop!
Lot of people outside.
There's literally toys on the floor. Why are you going for my foot?
In Los Angeles right now, right? The sun is out, it's warm, and kids are off of school because
he didn't
it
go
is
for it.
Good Friday. So, yes, there are a lot of people out. So, glad to see. It looks like he's moved out of the residential area into more
there
of an industrial area, Mike.
The extended parking area just off of LAX here on the north side as he continues southbound. And, boy, I tell you how he can drive when the car, with the shape that it's in, that large truck, hard to believe. Anyway, LAPD was the one that initiated the pursuit. I believe, Rich, was it a shooting suspect? Shooting
it's
suspect.
TOS,
and that's
no shot.
The only thing we know right
it's
now.
Live.
As you mentioned, Lou and Sandra, he could be armed. So that's why they're letting him do what
but
he's
doing. But
I
said leaning. That vehicle is leaning.
conditions.
Holy fuck.
They'll be able to either pit him or set up some type of containment around the car. He just turned westbound on Century. That was that right-hand turn. LAX is going crazy here, but they're doing a good job coordinating all the helicopters.
If there's an open gunfight and someone dies on stream, that is TOS.
Imagine, it's pretty crowded on the ground in the air.
What? Nah. No way.
Could start. And also, you
wait,
know,
really?
Little pieces of metal get shot everywhere. They end up on the road.
Yeah,
these
I think that'd be TOS,
also
right?
For other drivers. So the level of danger just keeps going up and
wait,
up.
Didn't Hassan literally show the last guy die on stream and nothing happened, though? So,
it's
I don't
really,
know.
You know, it seems almost impossible that this truck is still moving as it is. And you just wonder how much longer they are going to be able to maneuver this truck and
snitch.
Keep it going at 40
it's not
miles an hour. A lot of
bro, there's 50K people watching that shit.
The
fucking one person snitch.
It, keeping this truck on the road here, avoiding those officers at any cost, it appears. And we do know again that these people inside the truck are considered armed and dangerous. Going through another intersection here in Inglewood.
How is he driving this long with three wheels, bro?
That this driver is able to still maneuver the truck as they are.
How does he even turn?
On drugs or drinking or just agitated.
Fifth angle.
Again, he is a possible shooting suspect. And we've also seen him going through intersections pretty aggressively, also driving the opposite direction in lanes on surface streets. And he's done a couple of U-turns. And then at some point, he acted like he wanted to get on the freeway. And then at the last minute, turned back and decided to stay on the surface streets.
Yeah, we just saw him pass those pylons at LAX. This is what we do not want. We do not want an end of a pursuit near the airport.
Bro, this actually looks just like GTA.
Get out of town. A lot of people arriving in town. And you see this guy just hobbling along.
This is literally GTA Airport.
Again,
the road as well. Now it's broken off. You saw that wheel has broken off, and that's going to make it even harder to turn, and it's going to make that vehicle even hotter as far as potentially starting a fire.
Nah, bro.
Yeah, and you're right in the heart of the LAX area, and that's just causing a huge headache for not only...
Have you noticed how all these police chases are in LA chat? This place is actually MPC Central.
Okay. And he...
actually, why the fuck are they all in LA? What's up, Nem?
Nearly the amount of traffic and somehow has continued to be able to maneuver.
Nem, when can I come see you, man?
Guy to convince poor college kids that giving him money for private jets will get their student loans forgiven.
This is a murder suspect that is in, we believe,
whatever you want,
Silga. The passenger seat of this Chevrolet pickup truck, not driving. We have some reports. We have a belief that there might be a weapon in the vehicle. We do not know. We don't.
I wonder what's going through his head at this time.
Don't know the
like, his wheel's out. He knows that.
To the suspect.
Like, I was just trying to enjoy my last few minutes of freedom.
They don't know if this is an ally or an adversary in the vehicle. So that is going to be a very challenging part.
With the screeching of the fucking tire on the pavement. Police, because if they don't try and enjoy it.
This is a carjacking of some sort. That's going to create a very, very scary situation for the driver. If it is an ally, Bruce, would likely, if they know that, now we have damage. Look at this. The vehicle is trying to force his way through, and now we're under that overpass. People are going to try to get out of the way. You saw that vehicle just drive.
Holy
fuck. That is an expression of the desperation, it seems. Okay, so now you've got somebody opening the door.
Oh, no.
That is a person opening the passenger side
door.
Don't
jump.
Virtually disabled. No right wheel, but law enforcement right behind. So we are now going to see what's going to happen.
No, move. Pit forward, please.
Somebody is backing up.
Oh, shit.
Out, and now they're on the run. They're trying to get into another vehicle, and they
another car?
There are two women running away from the vehicle.
Oh, shit.
The suspect, it seems, has jumped into that vehicle. Maybe had been communicating with that because that person backed up and opened the door and got in. The two women ran away. So
Like they're gonna try and make it as if they fucking stole that.
SUV.
Yeah,
so
no
the vehicle
shot.
Was disabled.
Bro,
now you have another.
They held F on the car
with a murder suspect in the vehicle.
possibly assisted by another person who pulled up. We saw them backing up. They may have been in communication on the phone.
Shut up. Those people that just aided him are actually fucked. Why would they do that?
And so now we're going to possibly have one set of law enforcement going to try to get the two women. There were two women that we saw leaving. Now you've got a suspect who has another vehicle, and they are on the run. So this is a different kind of pursuit now. Instead of a disabled vehicle,
they stole their car or they were with him.
Could soon come to an end.
He didn't steal it. They backed up and they got out the car.
High speeds here near the airport.
They backed up.
And this suspect now driving into oncoming traffic, going through an intersection there.
What is this overlay?
It was against the light. Couldn't quite see that. But now you've got a very, very real problem here. Bruce, how does this change for law enforcement?
Bruce, tell us.
If you're back to square one, you're chasing a healthy vehicle which has not been spike stripped, does not have any disabling factors.
Damn.
And you're basically chasing a new vehicle. So it's starting over.
But now do you treat the suspects in this vehicle differently? Because now you have somebody who backed up and picked up this person. So do your tactics change as far as trying to end this? Because now we've got a suspect who just blew through a stop sign, went into oncoming traffic, and the community is at high risk.
Yeah, you are chasing a high-grade felony suspect who obviously has shown.
I can't wait for him to catch this asshole. Look at his smug face in the bottom right.
This, the safety of his life, the public, the police, everybody involved. So I would think if law enforcement gets a chance, they are probably going to try to do a pit maneuver on this vehicle, as they did not see the suspect with any kind of rifle.
Yeah, at that point, the person, we don't know if there was a handgun, but yeah, you're right. The person just ran, and you could actually see that they were not taking a weapon. So now you see an aggressive move by one of law enforcement coming up quickly on the left of that
The buckshot looks like E-Rob.
That person now
looks something like
weaving
him.
In and out of traffic. Again, this is at La Brea and Arbor, and the suspect getting through that intersection. It is a green light, but navigating through that congestion. And now, again, trying to elude authorities, and police are quickly back on this suspect, and we're coming through another green light, but turning on the right there and going down onto La Brea. So again,
I've been here, dude.
Same general area, passing another little minivan there on the left into oncoming traffic and aggressively trying to get away. So it looked like that was an intersection of Tamarack and Kelso, maybe, but it looks as if we're on Tamarack. So this suspect continues to blow through stop signs, which creates
Hassan be
a
like
real
wealth
problem
redistribution.
For anybody who might be driving.
Give them your money, he'll buy $5,000 jackets made by poor kids in third world countries.
So lunchtime, folks who, you know, we're spring break, there might be children out and about.
What?
But this suspect has really changed the dynamic of this chase. At first, we didn't know if this was maybe a carjacking and taking these two people
most random shit. What was that?
Were helping, but somehow this person into oncoming traffic now.
And honestly, fuck them kids, to be honest.
In the road, into oncoming traffic here.
I'm joking.
This is really incredibly dangerous.
Joking.
Now back into the proper lane. We're Manchester and South Prairie. And this suspect, high rate of speed.
Is this someone watching this or something?
Is not the suspect. They are now. They're part of this now. But the person authorities were immediately looking for was the passenger of a Chevy truck. This vehicle, if you're just now joining us, backed up when the Chevy was disabled and got this person, picked up the suspect, and took him off. So we do have some word here that two suspects who bailed out
it
says
Discord.
The driver carjacked a Mazda that they're still chasing. The two women we saw running, that's important. Out of the Chevy, they are in custody. They're called suspects in our note.
Actually, I don't want my second one announced,
believing
that I forgot.
This is a carjacking of this Mazda. It very possibly could be, I suppose. But Bruce, when we were watching, and I think you saw it as well, it looked to me like the Mazda backed up to pick up this person.
Yeah they definitely picked
exactly
him up.
What I saw.
They 100% picked him up, bro.
You know, but they are talking to those women and getting information, see if they are related or if they know this person. And they're going to sort through that pretty quickly. The good news is that you brought up the suspect in that vehicle is alone. There's not anybody else in that vehicle, which means law enforcement can be a little more aggressive.
It's just live, yeah, okay, it is.
So now you've seen there on the right what Bruce and I were talking about. This person running directly up to that vehicle that backed up to them. Now, we, you know, our word here, some of our notes, they are calling it a carjacking. So I think to Bruce's point, there's so much to be sorted out here. The two people who are in custody are being called suspects, but they're also going to sort that out and find out, were they allies or were they victims? This now is a very interesting case. This Mazda SUV that is on the run, aggressively driving, and that is where the suspect jumped into the back seat of this vehicle when that vehicle had backed up and apparently had stopped to pick him up. But we're now seeing, going through stop signs, we're seeing law enforcement get right up on the back of this Mazda. So how they approach this is going to be very interesting. A quick right turn here, now into either a side street or a parking lot. There you've got somebody with their lunch going into their car. That's what makes this so scary for the general public, is that this could happen and be up on them so quickly here just going about their business. It looks as if we're parallel to Manchester. Is that what we're hearing? Or yeah, alley parallel to Manchester. And now we're turning back onto Manchester in the opposite direction. So again, law enforcement right on the heels of this vehicle. And because they are in that area, Bruce, they could possibly throw another spike strip with possibility, because they've stayed in the general area, correct? That would give them a chance to do it.
Yeah, that's correct, Philip. You know, re-racking that footage,
bro,
of his suspect getting in that vehicle, you don't see the driver
catch us assholes.
You see the passenger open, but no one ever exits. So we might be back to square one with a driver and a suspect in
the
vehicle.
Twat, bro.
Oh, wait, actually, there might even be more people, Bruce. If you look at the vehicle, he gets into the back. Now watch the passenger side front open.
Yeah.
So no one gets
okay.
So
look, they've backed up, bro.
In the front and
okay,
one in the back.
Dude.
Surmise from what I just watched, unless somehow maybe the driver had reached across and possibly.
Where did the two women come from?
Pulled it back. So now you've got the.
I don't know if they're women involved, but the car definitely backed up. Someone picked him up.
Incredible what we watched. Oh,
someone picked him up.
Bruce, I have to admit, I thought the chase was about to end right at that spot. It looked as if the suspect was kind of pulling over and this was going to be a standoff. And then he jumped out and ran straight to that vehicle. Again, law enforcement is calling this a carjacking. We have to wait and see how that develops. But it does appear there could be at least two, possibly three people in that vehicle. Driving into oncoming traffic again. So, Bruce, I assume they would, again, we're back to square one, except now we know that that suspect is not carrying a rifle with them.
Right. And we are going to continually go with the fact of him being armed and dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
And being a murder suspect also. But, yeah. I think you're correct. I think there may be two or three people in that vehicle, possibly.
Which, again,
there's at least
with
two
tinted windows in the back. You know, once it reaches
at
its
least
end
two.
Point, that creates a piece of the puzzle for law Answer enforcement Dwinks's when they're question. Trying to secure the vehicle, trying to clear the vehicle, trying to know how what,
so
what they're
square.
Facing. Because you don't really tell me the approach of law enforcement here, Bruce. You don't like
I
the
ain't
unknown
answering.
When it comes to a standoff. Or engaging of a suspect. You like to know what you're facing.
Yeah, that's correct. I mean, you want to control the situation. And you're controlling it, you're containing it, because you want to keep the unknowns from happening. However, the officers are going to have plan A, B, C, and D in this case when this finally ends.
So I'm going to ask our producer as we're talking. I was just told they were
new information
were
just dropped the driver
as
a Twitch streamer formerly known as Comedy
suspect,
Russell now just Russell.
Total? Because as Bruce and I were saying, it doesn't look as if it's two people total. It does appear. Okay, we're told that they are approaching this as two people in the car. Now you see another move here to try to go through the traffic congestion, getting into the turn lane, going around. So we'll figure out the number of people in the car as we go forward. That seems an odd circumstance, Bruce, but I'm going to go with with what they're saying on the scanner and what authorities are saying is possible. And again, they're calling this a carjacking. But from
bro, I wonder what music they're listening to in the car.
It was a strange sequence of events to watch the vehicle back up and somebody jump in, and very possibly the suspect. Maybe,
you think they listen
the
to any music?
Trying to get out of the passenger side.
I can just imagine them listening to this,
Bruce,
bro.
And the person said, "Don't you dare get back in here and drive." But who knows? They're calling it carjacking, and they're saying there are two people in the vehicle. But we'll say at least two people in the vehicle at this point. You see the vehicle once again. This Mazda SUV, once again, still near the airport,
World War
still
me.
Driving the same general area. And did you see? Wow, that was an aggressive move by law enforcement to jump up because it looked as he was trying to make that right turn again. That might have taken him in the direction of the airport. So now look at this. Up onto the median. Oh. In the center of the vehicle, up or on the road, up on the median, driving down the left turn lane. Here we make a left turn right there, nearly hitting that vehicle, getting control back in the left lane, and making that right turn there. So whoever's driving is driving aggressively to try to get away. Looks like they've now got into a parking structure of some sort. If that is the case, there he goes again. So they pulled into that lot and then came right back out. I thought maybe might be going into a building underneath, but again,
oh, shit.
Back on the road, trying to get away. And we again have high rates of speed here. And again, if you're just joining us, we want to let you know this is a somewhat
Miles
difficult
Keith
chase
gets up and hit the
sub
shaker before
HD
I leak who was in the car.
Okay.
Jesus.
We now we're into oncoming traffic. People have the right of way. This person driving through the red light, a person there in the sidewalk, in the crosswalk, stopping for all the authorities, and now that person is stuck as the light gets ready to turn green. Here goes the Mazda
suspect
SUV
has been named Matthew Strays, dressed in and is
regular,
said to be armed.
Driving side
Strays.
Back on the right side of the road, but showing.
Bro, did this guy just leak your name? Bro, he just doxed him.
Strays,
just get doxed.
Up on the median that was dividing the two. Now that's interesting.
Bro, just got doxed.
On to oncoming traffic around the left turn
what?
Lane to keep that person from going that direction. So Bruce,
that's wild, bro.
Of what you were talking about a moment ago, they are trying to get this person to go in a certain place.
Bro's name is Matthew Dresden.
Yeah, that's what I think we're saying here. They are requesting additional resources from other stations, maybe even other agencies under mutual aid to get them, hey, block Manchester. Florence, whatever street it may be.
So his surname is Dresden, bro.
And deploy additional spike strips.
And that's the thing. If they can get spike strips on it, again, you start to reduce the possibility.
What'd you from your PlayStation? PlayStation off. Xbox off. Xbox off. PlayStation off.
Sadly, how this can
Alexa, volume 10. Alexa, play Booty 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 Rockin' Everywhere.
Drive at high rates of speed. Has shown a willingness to kind of force. Well, when it was the truck, when they were driving the.
How the fuck did she hear me from that far? What the fuck? Bro. That's actually wild. Okay. Alexa! 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 Alexa, stop.
This vehicle. We did not see a rifle of any sort, but now the person is trying to navigate through and against the light and now into the turn lane, trying to get around that box truck, which he has done effectively.
Bro!
With the help of-
Alexa! 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 Stop! Okay, that weren't worth it, bro. That was not fucking worth it. That weren't worth it.
Hey, E-Money, do you know
I'm not furry, no.
From the one game Last of Us is him writing an essay on a review of the game.
We saw that on a pursuit the other day on Channel 7, where they were just flooding the area with law enforcement and were able to close off intersections, funneling the suspect vehicle into an area that they wanted.
Yeah, and if you funnel them into an area with no, with a cul-de-sac or with some sort of industrial complex, that's going to be much better. But every time he goes through an intersection, it just puts so many people at risk because this is a busy time of day out there. You've got a
this
lot
is what I'm
of
imagining they're listening to in the car right now. Time. This type of music.
And so now you've got a guy willing to drive into oncoming traffic, potentially carjack this vehicle, alleged carjacking. It is possible. There you have another blocked intersection. Now on Manchester. So that's got to be an interesting thing in the vehicle.
Ow.
Every intersection that goes by when you might want to turn one direction and you can't because law enforcement's already there. Bruce, at what point does the futility of this begin to set in? Go back here, 7. There's a U-turn. They did a U-turn right there. Just behind, there it is. Now they did the U-turn.
Almost lost his ass.
Great camera work. So the.
Okay, so now you're just pausing the fucking stream. Okay, buddy. Like, you're gonna have to move. Bro.
U-turn and traffic. There's a man carrying garbage out of the McDonald's. And here we are in this area. Now we've got another right turn into oncoming traffic. No, that's actually, I'm sorry, that is proper traffic side, but. You could see he was weaving wide, and I thought for a second there he was going to come across the lanes. So here we are on a street, looks like Main Street.
Just give up, bro. It's over.
86th. So this suspect on a little bit of a street less traveled. So this, we don't know if this is an opportunity
just give up.
For pit maneuver. We can't really see the speeds at this point. They look to be between 50 and 60 miles an hour. But now into that left turn lane. And weaving a little bit. That might have been a spike strip. Bruce, is that probably what the suspect did? Turned into the oncoming traffic?
Okay, don't so let they... this yeah, chase distract you from the fact that Tri-Comedy Russell has killed three people in the metro Austin area.
So they are getting to display spike strips in and around that area.
And now you see going through a crosswalk there again. You start to wonder about Troy
Russell.
Areas of kids that are just out and about.
Troy Comedy Russell
it's
Russell.
Friday. Now you see possibly another maneuver to avoid, but driving into the turn lane again at 98th Street and Main into the oncoming traffic lane. Looks like there's some damage to the front of this vehicle,
okay,
too. So now we see on another side street, and it looks as if, that was going to try to go down that that alleyway there. And so now we
put
see
on Mario music.
Navigate a
no.
street that in many cases... You don't have room for two people to go by because it's you've got so many people parked on the road, and it's usually an exchange of opportunity for traffic to and fro. Now
bro, get away!
Quick right turn, going down a street, and it looks like they're approaching another main street here, which is going to Century. That's Century, crossing Century, and then no, making a left turn. And then now we're bound on Century, back onto one of the main streets there. And here we go again. But we've seen opportunity for law enforcement, and they have taken it to deploy spike strips here and there. At this point, the person has been able to avoid that. Bruce, I mean, again, we're still trying to figure out the relationship with the people
on
the vehicle,
Benny Hill
so
theme.
They're probably going to gather that information
Benny
so they can run the plates on this vehicle, yes?
Hill. What happened?
Have we lost Bruce?
No, I'm sorry. I lost you guys just for.
Okay, sorry about that. But again, same story as the first. You run the plates on the Chevy to find out the connection. You're gonna run
don't
the
let
plates
fucking
on this
Drake
Mazda
hear this
as well, correct? And find out if there's a relationship here. If this indeed is a carjacking, because that's what it's called.
A carjackman?
Find out. Where the registered owner address comes back to, which may be in the area that we are at.
We're told that this is a female driver, which there were two women that got out of the Chevy. So if this is another carjacking, then he has carjacked another female as he did before, or unless those were allies. And so now,
bro's jacked another female.
See what goes on with this.
Bro has stolen a female.
General area, murder suspect in pursuit, or being pursued by LAPD. Coming up on a red light here, slowing down.
Mr. Steal Your Girl,
which is good. And but here we go around the bus, and then continuing on forward. So of course. Approaching the intersections with some caution, but still driving in the lane. Trying to see if that front passenger seat is a person in a white t-shirt, or if that may be something just laying there on. You see some hand movements, some gesturing by the person who's driving. Yep, it looks like there is a person in the front seat.
Oh, shit, it's two.
If I'm remembering correctly, the person who was on the run was wearing t-shirts, yes? I can't remember if they were wearing a white t-shirt. I remember they had dark hair, so maybe if we happen to see that as this vehicle got carjacked. But you see some hand movements there by the person driving. You see this someone in the front seat, and when we re-rack, we'll see exactly what the person was wearing and see if it's the same, if the suspect has moved from the back. No. So, okay, we have a black shirt.
How did I zoom the camera in? No,
we have a white
shirt
t-shirt in the front. With the woman driving. So, Bruce, I'm back to thinking there are three people in this vehicle.
Yeah, Philip, that's a great observation.
I was going to say, how do they position the camera so well on the car, but be flying a different direction? Do they, like, aim it out, or is the camera, like, mounted on the bottom of the helicopter?
So I think that does kind of force law enforcement to be not as aggressive as a solo vehicle. Suspect.
Is it mounted onto the bottom?
On the
mounted, okay,
so
cool.
You have the driver, who cool, is said cool. to be a woman, on the phone, and if perchance, if Mike and your...
This song's so bad, okay, I'll put Hawaii 5-0 on fever.
Somehow the person in black contacted this person, and they picked him up. Then this person could potentially make a phone call for another exchange to let this person have another vehicle. To get out of there, because as we've all seen, when you stay in the same community, wow, a person on a bicycle nearly hit by the Mazda coming through there.
My
and there's
fucking
a pedestrian
God, bro.
Right underneath Air 7 as this person is driving through. So the general.
Where do they think they can get away? I'm confused.
But we don't know what's going on with.
It doesn't make sense in my brain.
This chase. This is being called a carjacking, but the front seat is occupied. The driver is on the cell phone, and the murder suspect.
Wish you wouldn't do shit, bro. You'd just break down and cry.
And we believe they are.
You break one of your nails trying to open up the car door and start crying.
Three people in this vehicle.
You just sit there.
We are told by authorities it's only two. Now you see another turn right in front of the vehicle, but you see the damage to the hood. So Bruce, I mean, you have to treat that as a possibility, right? That we've seen this person jump out and get into another vehicle. Now we see the driver on the phone. You have to assume.
Oh shit! Another helicopter.
This might happen again.
Oh, POV, POV.
Yeah, Philip, you're 100% correct. The other thing too, which might be happening, is
bro, there's like three birds in the sky. God damn!
This could be a relative who is in the murder suspect, and this could be a mom or an aunt or a sister who's saying, "Yeah, I'm in this vehicle. We want to stop. We want to surrender, but we want no harm to come to our relative."
Okay, well, now we're approaching the 105 freeway. And at this point of the chase that we've watched, this person has not gotten onto a freeway. They've continued to drive surface streets near the airport. Okay, now the person...
This guy's foolish.
Off the phone.
Both
hands on the wheel that you can see there.
Oh, he's actually a responsible driver. Wow.
The cell phone was handed off to somebody else. Bruce, you make a great point. This could be a, hey, we want to surrender, but this is where we want to do it. This is how we want to do it. It could be anything. And it could also be.
Bruce actually got his hands on the fucking wheel like this.
We just don't know.
Oh.
It's just an odd chase, Bruce, in that we thought it was almost over. And usually, Bruce, when we see a carjacking, there is some manner of resistance by the person being.
It's a woman who's driving.
Here we go into oncoming traffic through another intersection.
Was it a woman who was driving previously?
And back on the move again without hitting anything. That's good. But usually there's some manner.
No.
Of
this is the one who picked him up.
Whether it's I opened the driver's side door and tried to get out, or something. And that's what was unusual.
Oh, she's being held hostage by gunpoint.
Is that the only door that opened was the passenger door. The suspect jumped into the rear of this vehicle. And without any,
bro, if someone was holding me hostage by gunpoint like this, I would try and crash somehow on purpose. Probably.
That's usually the behavior of somebody.
I would try and crash on purpose somehow.
They just want out of that vehicle and
no, you wouldn't.
So it's
yeah, I would. Like, I'll try and crash into something.
We saw where there was
no not hard.
From the people
not hard.
The vehicle. They stayed
but
there,
as we're turning a corner, like crashing to a wall or something.
Got it. Didn't open the front door and try to pull the person out. Jumped in the back.
Then you get shot. No, because it's an accident. They wouldn't shoot you.
And then shuts, and nobody even made an attempt to get out of that vehicle as those two women ran straight by. Those two women have been detained by authorities, and now we're looking at what authorities are calling.
Wait, what was he in there for again?
But looked.
Why are they chasing him in the first place?
Carjacking we've ever witnessed here before. So now we see this Mazda going into the right shoulder, driving.
Attempted murder. See, look, he couldn't even kill the person. He couldn't even kill the person. Then, and therefore, I wouldn't be scared
again,
of him.
And here we go through an intersection, trying to make a decision to go right or left. Basically, it's just navigating those intersections. If I could have our producer say what they said in the ear one more time. Okay, so that's Imperial and San Pedro is the road that we're on. So
you're an
Imperial
easier target.
Is the road, and that is, you know, a
shooting at some
easy
apartments.
Road to
drive. Jesus
so we're
fucking
really
Christ,
good
bro.
Look into the driver. Who is navigating this, and we can see the white t-shirt person to her right. We cannot see into the back seat. That is where we believe the murder suspect jumped into the vehicle out after being running away from the truck. So Bruce, this is at this point kind of just another chase at this point. The officers are just trying to find a way to navigate them into where they can disable this vehicle, huh?
Yeah, that's correct. You know, Imperial Highway is a multi-lane east-west street, mostly a commercial area. And as they continue further east, you're going to transverse into Sheriff's Territory, Maywood PD, maybe Vernon. And you know, I'd be curious to know where this suspect is wanted out of, meaning what jurisdictional area. But to your point, Philip, this is unlike any carjacking we've ever seen. Most people, like you said, would resist, maybe speed up, maybe try to get out of the way. But in this case, this vehicle backed up, and they let this person get into the rear seat.
Three police chases in 3 weeks. I think there's a police chase in L.A. every day, bro.
Bruce, we've got the rear.
Like, probably multiple a day.
That is lost air. And you can see it there very clearly from Air 7 HD. Well, that was a little bit of a we can get a focus better on that one. But you could see it a moment ago very clearly. The back wheel is flat. On the driver's side, rear wheel is gone. So that means you're going to have the same.
You really
want to
leave beautiful England for this country. I wouldn't call England beautiful,
the
bro.
The propulsion will be affected. Well, this might be a front-wheel drive.
But this place is cool. Jing school, slow. Here, what does Jing mean?
In many cases, some of these are front-wheel drive, so maybe it won't affect it as much. But either way, it'll affect control.
Crossing. Yeah. Oh,
excellent. You're also, you're dealing with a heavier tonnage vehicle, just like the pickup. It's a little larger SUV. I do believe this is a rear-wheel drive vehicle. So as that tire disintegrates, the rim disintegrates, it's going to lock up. And that may cause some issues.
That's so dumb. It says zing. You know, it said zing. Like, don't try to tell us it's crossing again now. But I said zing, bro.
I think that authorities are not going to take for granted that it's been disabled.
This is what pain looks like.
Now
please pause for a word from our sponsor fans.
Ready in the event that this vehicle does stop, because it's happened once. We've seen the suspect jump out, run from one vehicle to another. And we've seen the driver of this vehicle on the phone. So now we're about to see how long
bro,
this monster
his
will
ass
be able to run with
bro.
A disabled rear left tire. Just running a red light there. But it's a little less dangerous at this speed, Bruce, because not only is it you're not going through there so with such surprising appearance to oncoming traffic, but you have... One, two, four,
play some
five,
funk.
Six, seven police cars. You've got to think the commuters know now what's happening because lights and sirens in that neighborhood are going to be resounding. And so they will probably see this coming. So here we've got a right turn, and they're now off of that. That was the Imperial Highway, I believe. And now they've moved on to one of the side streets as well. It looks like 87th Street is where, or in that neighborhood. That's what that street is. 88. So they're 88. So Air 7 is above 87th. That is on 88. And so they are driving again. And in many of these
bumpy areas, hiding, buddy.
These little side streets we've seen, there are speed bumps as well. So here we go. We have an officer in front. They've blocked traffic, and the person was able to go right on through. And we're seeing that more and more, Bruce. More and more often, we're seeing law enforcement at an intersection in front of them. And so that means they see it, too.
Yeah, what they're doing is they're letting, it's more of a public safety issue also, to block the intersection to allow the suspect vehicle.
Yo, what's up, Sully?
And the parade of police cars to get through safely, in addition to also funneling them into an area they want them to be
at. Oh, my God, that sounds so bad, bro.
And right now, one of the reasons they wanted to funnel them in a place is so they could get spike strips out. Clearly, the suspect in this case avoided a couple, but did not avoid all, because one of them has flattened the rear tire. And so it might have even happened, Bruce, when on
that's
one of those,
a classic
efforts to avoid.
That's
it
a completely. Classic.
I mean, that struck me as odd that it was able to disable the rear wheel, not the front. But it's possible, I suppose, that when she swerved to
didn't
miss it on the back end, and that's what disabled that back tire. Does that happen frequently?
Right. Yeah. Also,
Initial D had some of the best music.
There, it's a tack strip. It's actually three parts that will, as you throw it out. So
we're playing this song, yet he's going like 40 miles per hour. He's really not going fast at all.
The tires of the police vehicles in the pursuit. I actually had that once on a robbery suspect where I couldn't get it out of the way in time, and a police vehicle.
Oh, I forgot it's a woman driving.
Got four flat tires. So it's a real tricky maneuver.
Well, we saw that in that barricades situation a couple of weeks ago, where one of the officers ran over it and disabled that vehicle when they had called out SWAT special enforcement or sheriff special enforcement and had the.
Bro, I'm kind of over this chase.
So that was quite the day. And then now we have this, which is a very unusual situation. We don't know the relationship of the people in the vehicle, if it is a carjacking or if
it was hype when the car had no wheel
again,
but now they're just driving. I'm kind of bored.
Was nearly over when a Chevy truck had plowed through an intersection with basically no front wheel. It was perpendicular.
I want to watch a movie,
way
bro.
Of travel. The wheel was about to fall off and collapse, but
dude, I was watching a movie last night in Gigi's chat, and she fell asleep while the movie was playing. And then Once Upon a Time in Hollywood started playing on autoplay, bro, and she almost got fucking banned, bro. Like, that movie is so bad. Like, it's like literally
jumped into the back of this vehicle. And that's when the sex. Monster took off.
Dude.
We all words, shit in there, you know? It's bad, bro.
And I believe that. Go to college, graduate, we are seeing the suspect live drive through an intersection against the light.
Get residual. Holy
so
shit.
So that was an intersection that officers were not able to get to. They can't get to all of them, Bruce. Do they just decide we're going to pick one that we can throw a spike strip down so it doesn't affect other traffic, and they just kind of, like you said, maneuver them to that place? Because they can't throw it down at every single intersection.
No, you don't have those resources. It's kind of a hidden.
Why is Bruce's mic so fucking bad?
This guy is driving eastbound on, you know, Imperial Highway. Any units on Imperial Highway, act up where you are. Maybe you're ahead, maybe you're behind. And if you have a spike strip, maybe you can deploy it.
But everybody doesn't carry one, huh?
No, that's correct. We just don't have the resources for that.
Okay. So anyway, and again, another part of this is since this suspect stays in the general area, officers are able to block intersections and maybe not put down spike strips, but certainly protect the general public as they can because of this particular driver who now goes through another intersection against the flow of traffic.
Do something,
did
dude.
Not have the right of way. Drove through that intersection on a flat
You're
tire.
Boring.
The
do
best
something.
News of this pursuit, per se, is that this person is not able to go at the rates of speed they were going earlier. They've not gotten on freeways. They have stayed in the general area of 87th, Imperial, Century. There was one point with the Chevy truck that it looked as if this driver was going, or the other driver was going, to take this murder suspect into the terminal area of LAX, but They did a U-turn, went back the general direction, and we haven't seen that opportunity again. It did seem at one point that the suspect driving right now, the person driving right now, might have had that as an idea, but officers quickly closed the gap and kept them from being able to get anywhere near the terminal. Now you see, again, that left rear tire.
What would I advise? I'd advise getting a car that can actually catch up to this and then ramming him off the road.
Normally see on a tire, so clearly it loses.
That's what
its
I would do.
Slowly,
I'd get two cars like this, and I'd corner him being thrown out and like that.
Of the vehicle. So
you can't drive anymore.
The passenger side window is cracked. We saw the driver's side window all the way down. This person now driving into the left turn lane to get around and then into
killing the hostage
back into its regular lanes, splitting the two lanes here. Now you see vehicles in front starting to pull over smartly and get out of the way. But you have law.
Okay, then I teleport the hostage. I tell the hostage.
But we do have a high felony suspect, murder suspect in that vehicle, and they are not going to just back.
It's not a hostage anyway. She picked him up. Fuck it. She's guilty too. Ram them both.
Turn. There's a person using one of the scooters trying to cross the road with no idea what's happening. Again, Bruce, that's the kind of thing that I'm talking about. When they go through there with a flattened tire, it makes it a lot safer for everybody.
Yeah, it does, because it decreases their speed. You know, also, as you get into these residential streets, some schools are still in session. Some only have half days. So the population is more out and about.
Half-day schools? I never, ever in my life have had a half-day.
Yeah, certainly with a Good Friday, a lot of schools,
perfect.
Even if they are in session, will it be out today? When I say that,
it's Easter
maybe
weekend.
In session until yesterday. Now you've got, you know, and you've
we've
got
had those. I've never
right
had a half-day in my life, bro.
Who is trying to? It is leading police on this chase, but again, you can take a look at that back rear tire, and you see it is down. It is completely flat. The front tires are okay. But if this is a
did you go to school? Yes, but I never got early out.
It's going to be difficult to continue moving forward as soon as the rubber completely goes off.
But we finished an hour earlier than every other school. So I guess that's how they added it up.
The steering of it, Bruce, will be a lot easier with the tires on the front. But you'll start trying to accelerate, and it'll just
no. We started an hour later, I think. Actually, never mind. We started an hour later, but we finished at the same time. So maybe that's how they added it up. I don't fucking know.
On concrete, once the metal gets to the asphalt.
Yeah, the spike strips are designed.
They take the short bus.
Like little mini, I'll call them straws for.
Dude, if you get a week, if you get a half day off for Easter Friday, if you're a Muslim, you should get the whole month off for Ramadan. That's what I say. You should get the whole month off.
Like we've seen. And then they're riding on rims. So it's also a safety issue that it doesn't deflate the tire right away, but it just takes time.
Well, I noticed that the driver had her arm out the window. I couldn't tell if she got behind the tree. I couldn't tell if she was dropping something. So she did. We're told that she dropped the bag, and now again you'll see some
hand movements there bag.
By the driver. And so officers will stop and pick up whatever that bag was. And they will look into that. So what would be anything that might help in that circumstance, Bruce, when they drop some bag out of the window?
You know, maybe there's a wallet in there. Maybe there's an ID with a valid address on it. Maybe that gives the officers some idea.
Did you have watchtowers and a wall and regular security roaming around your school? No.
Person's address.
What?
Ultimately, and maybe they're in
you weren't even allowed a phone in my school. If you brought a phone to school and you got caught with it out, you literally got it removed from you. And you had to get your mom to come in to get you back.
Yeah. I was just going to say, Phil, you know, as we've seen in these pursuits,
it was bullshit,
no line,
bro.
There's no reason. And they just go.
You weren't even allowed a watch. If you had a watch at school and it was a digital watch, you weren't allowed it.
They don't want to just
I'm pretty sure.
And surrender. They want their last 5 minutes of freedom.
And you had to wear a uniform.
Well, in this suspect,
the first school I went to before I went to my other school, you had to have a certain amount of stripes on your tie, otherwise you got a detention.
So we've had two vehicles involved in one pursuit of a murder suspect. And as Bruce mentioned,
I'm not trolling, bro. If you didn't have a certain amount of stripes on your tie,
not only
you got a detention.
Heavy
there was like four different ties one red, one green, one blue, one yellow for the four different house colors of the house of the school.
Whatever,
it was in different houses. And then you had to have a certain, I think it was 14 stripes on your tie, otherwise you got a detention.
You are,
it's not Hogwarts.
It doesn't matter what the bail is. This person might be held in custody, and they're going to stay there until trial.
So Hogwarts, bro. Yeah, everyone had houses in the UK. You have the House Cup at the end of the year.
No bail,
you do sports day, and you compete for the House Cup. That isn't true thing in the UK. That is a thing, bro.
To be a little more aggressive. You know, maybe force the hand.
I'm not lying.
Tri-pit maneuvers. Just say, hey, we're not going anywhere, so pull over. Let's end this thing. Come on.
Yeah. And as we look here, you can start to see, you see that rear tire really start to disintegrate. 43rd and Hoover, it looks like. Now, that is probably Hoover.
Is it's that, a fictional country. Can, bro, we every year we have the Tri-Wizard tournament. Anyway, back, no, it's called Sports Day. Roads, okay? And every house has people that compete in the sports, and whoever wins overall, you get the House Cup.
Here. You see, that's the weaving.
Depending on how many points
away,
you get.
We do think that might be where they got the spike strip, at least into the rear tire. As Bruce said, just a slow, steady leak of air. And so now the person that is driving this vehicle has a, now you see the rubber starting to come off the back. If you look at the rear wheel,
Marie Curie guy. Well, you had a house called Curie.
You'll see that the rubber is just starting to disintegrate now. Or
what were your house? What house were you? I was in Blue House.
Rubber is now.
My house was called Armstrong after Neil Armstrong, and it was blue.
Come off because if you can imagine the tire is coming off in bits. And it's some of it's still going to be attached, and it's just going to be like a chain.
There was four different houses. They were named after like people that did like great shit. So there was like Einstein,
can't really tell
Armstrong, Curie,
there, but that's got to be unsettling Babbage inside the vehicle to start hearing. Okay, there's a lot of rubber that came.
Babbage,
so
I think it's called Babbage.
You have pretty much nothing on that rear tire. If they did want to do a pit, Bruce, it's a lot easier when the vehicle is disabled in this manner, yes?
Yeah, that it is. As parts of the vehicle start to disintegrate and fall off,
wasn't in Curie, no, it was in Armstrong.
Frame, more into the wheel well, more into the vehicle axle area, so the pit maneuvers become more effective.
Mm-hmm. But you still see so many people coming out to see what's going on. You see kids there on the sidewalk walking along. It looks like that is a church. You see a lot of vendors there on the sidewalks, and you just want, you're wanting to pick the proper
Boys, I think I'm done. I think I'm done watching this. I think I'm done streaming today.
And of course,
I think if you want to watch this, there's other people streaming this shit anyway, so you may as well just go watch them. I think E-Rob's streaming it. I think if you want, Hassan's streaming it. Mizkiff's streaming it. I don't know. Everyone seems to be streaming it anyway. And hey, boys, it's been a long day. I'm gonna head off, but I hope you guys had a great fucking, day watching the stream. I had a great time. Yes. All right, boys, take care, look after yourselves. I'll be back, wait, what day is it today? I'll be back tomorrow, on Saturday. The weigh-in is tomorrow with Russell. I think I'll probably do something as well, like some workout video or some shit. Take care, chat, look after yourselves. Have a great rest of your day. Thanks for the subs, resubs, etc. You guys mean the fucking world to me, especially you guys who are here right now. Everyone else is live, and my boys are here. This is the core boys right here. So I appreciate you specifically. All right, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care, boys. Bye bye. Rolling me down the highway, rolling me down the highway. Moving ahead so life won't pass me by. Like a north wind whistling down the sky. I've got a song, I've got a song. Like a whippoorwill and the babies cry. I've got a song, I've got a song. And I carry it with me and I sing it loud. If it gets me nowhere, I go there proud. Moving me down the highway,
died a dream. They can change their minds, but they can't change me. I've got a dream. I've got a dream. Oh, I know I could share it if you want me to. If you're going my way, I'll go with you. Bend me down the highway. Don't let me down the highway. Moving ahead so life won't pass me by. Bend me down the highway. Don't let me down the highway. Moving ahead so life won't pass me by.
There was a time when I was alone, nowhere to go and no place to call home. Their only friend was the man in the moon, and even sometimes he would go away too. Then one night as I closed my eyes, I saw a shadow flying high. He came to me with the sweetest smile, told me he wanted to talk for a while. He said, Peter Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely. And ever since that day, I am a lost boy from Netherland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me, away from all of reality. And Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Twinkle me in pixie dust and told me to believe, believe in him and believe in me. Together we will fly away in a cloud of green to your beautiful destiny. As we soared above the town that never loved me, I realized I finally had a family. Soon enough we reached Neverland. Peacefully my feet hit the sand. And ever since then, I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me, away from all of reality. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Peter Pan, Tinkerbell, Wendy, darling, even Captain Hook, you're my perfect storybook. Neverland, I love you so, you are my home sweet home forever, a lost boy at last. Peter Pan, Tinkerbell, Wendy, darling, Captain Hook, you're my perfect storybook. Neverland, I love you so, you are now my home sweet home forever, a lost boy at last. And always I will say, I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we'll play in the woods, he's on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boys, they say to me. Away from all of reality. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and foursome boys like me are free. Twitch TV is home to foursome boys like me, and foursome boys like me are free. Wait, are we at 6 hours yet? Oh, fuck. Wait, one more then.
Find out the truth when I get back.
forgotten the old ways. At the bottom of the ocean, now has swallowed the only thing that's left is us. So pardon the silence that you're hearing. Deafening pain.